Woo! Sexy people of the interwebs. This will be a quick one. Just want to visit with y'all for a minute. It's, y'all gotta know something. Ooh, that's cobbler in there. They was out of peach, so had to get apple. Apple cobbler's okay. Not a whole lot of apple in there. Not a whole lot of apple in there. So you know. Let's see what we got for Dan Dan. Let's catch y'all up before we go through the sack. Oh yeah. Ryanator's in there. First one in the house. Bob. Sydney. Alright. So went over to Orrick, Missouri. Got loaded really fast. And tore ass for Texas. Anybody who bothers to read the titles, whenever these things pop up, you'll know that I'm already here. Yeah, I'm about between 2 and 3 miles from the delivery. I don't deliver till 1:30 tomorrow evening. I was gonna go home tonight. I'm gonna tell you what happened to me. On the way down, I stopped off in Arkansas. Stopped off at the Pilot Flying J there, and I just needed to use the restroom, get my little 30-minute break in, and I was a little hungry, and they didn't have any of the foods or anything like that. They didn't have anything, no pizza, no nothing, and whatever restaurant was there was gone, fast food. So the hot dogs were the freshest thing in the building and hot. And I didn't just want the beef hot dog because I tend to burp those for hours or days away and then fart them. So I wanted the one with the jalapeno and the cheese in it. Yeah. That was a mistake. That was a mistake of biblical proportions. I'll tell you what. Talking about bubble guts. Woo! Man, I had to eat me a half a bag of chips, put that on there, and drank a bunch of Pepsi and Gatorades and water and everything I could to get my stomach to settle down. I had already decided I was going to sleep in Oklahoma. I don't mean to say anything bad about Oklahoma. I don't like sleeping there. So, I got it under control. And I come on down here. And I stopped at my little spot here. I knew that there would be places open. Because all the spots here are paid. If you get a spot that's TA. He's a funny man. The TA spots over here, they're $15. The rest of the spots are $10. All paid. The whole fucking thing. So, I knew I'd find a spot. Everything up this way is paid. You know, the Pilot right there, right outside of Texarkana, that's paid. Everything's paid. I'm sorry. I want to apologize. You know, being from Texas, we don't usually do that shit. I don't know why they did that shit. They're trying to make a little bit of money. There's another Pilot right up the street from here, I think. It's paid too. Yeah. So, the reason I stopped here. Hey, Vibes, how you doing? Oh, yeah. Yeah, everything's fine. Fine and dandy. The reason I stopped here is this TA Express. It's also like a Sefco or something. I don't know. I don't know what it is. But it's a Duke's. Now, in Canton, we have a Duke's. And Duke's always has barbecue. If you get there early enough. That's right. Ooh, look at that brisket. Look at that sausage. That Texas toast. That mashed taters and them green beans. You have no idea how good this smells. You have no idea. Yeah. But it also, in another way, because I try to look at things from the opposite so I don't, you know, feel like somebody's, you know, taking something from me. At least I know that this place ain't gonna be filled up with a bunch of mega carrier dudes. You know what I mean? Yeah, it don't just look good. It smells good. I don't know if it tastes good, but it surely smells real good. I'm gonna have to have me a little piece of that. Whoo, man, that brisket looks so good. When he picked it up, man, it started falling apart. And I'm like, oh, don't touch that with the knife. Oh, it don't need that. Look at that. Look how fucking gorgeous. Look at that char on there. And it's got a little pink around the edges. Oh, man. Mm. It's as good as it smells, as good as it looks. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna have to put this away for a minute because I don't want to make y'all jealous. I don't want to hurt y'all's feelings. Let me just close this. Let me just close this for a minute. So that's why I come over here. Hey, Smooth. That's why I pushed myself. Yeah, I'd say it was a 10 out of 10. Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty good. I hadn't tried the rest of the fixing, so we'll see. I'll tell y'all in the next video. Well, you didn't get to see it there. Shit. Damn, Smooth. All right, so what we've got here is your basic Texas brisket barbecue with the sausage, the green beans that got every damn thing in them. I think there's some bacon off in there. They better have some bacon off in there. Mashed taters and some Texas toast. Yeah. And a side apple cobbler. That's right. I wanted peach cobbler, but they were out. I settled for apple, but that's okay. And coconut pies. That's right. That's another reason why I came over. Because they got a bakery here at this one. And they bake up the coconut pies right there. Oh, yes, they do. Oh, yes. Oh, it's good stuff. I might put it right over here because I keep smelling it. I'm going to show you these pies, though. This ain't no normal pie. This is from the original fried pie shop. Look at the size of these sons of bitches. Big-ass pie. Yeah, that's coconut in there, man. Whoo. She gave me four of them for $3.50. I believe she gave me a bargain. Because it looked like $10 a piece. They're so damn big. They're huge. I had to get four of them, you know. Sorry, didn't mean to make you hungry. Just wanted to, you know, share with y'all what I'm doing over here. The reason for coming. So I pushed through, man. I pushed through some really bad bubble guts. And I put it down. I had to go through the fucking mountains to get here. Not that bad, but when you got bubble guts and the pressure, it builds and it's horrible, man, horrible. But I made it through, and I hauled ass down here. I'm a couple miles from the drop, and now I can sleep late. Cause I don't have to drop till 1:30 in the evening. I'm gonna go early, obviously, but I can sleep a little later, and then I gotta go and get money together because he likes cash. He'll take plastic, but he likes cash. So I'm gonna have to go put my cash together and go pay for Betty, get Black Betty out the shop. And I'm thinking I'm gonna take Black Betty home and put her on the battery charger and then unhook the batteries and let her sit. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Hey, David, how you doing? And then, that way I can get my shit together to put it back in Black Betty, like my refrigerator that's sitting out on the front porch, and then I gotta strap that down. I gotta go buy another microwave. This is the microwave out of Black Betty. But my other six microwaves don't work. For one reason or another. It's crazy. The refrigerators went bad, the microwaves went bad, but I mean, who cares? They're they're expendable. I mean, they're cheap. You just throw them away. I got a yard full of that shit. And I'll get Black Betty back in working condition. I'm gonna go ahead and put the new mud flaps on. And the number one cylinder, the injector number one cylinder, the bonnet came off. It came apart. It just that was the metallic sound bouncing around in there. Number one cylinder. Don't ask me which one that is. I don't know. I don't have a clue. I don't know which one's the number one cylinder on a kitty cat like that, 3406E. I don't know. But they replaced the injector and the little exhaust hose coming off of the turbo, because that dude was rusted, and we ripped that dude in half. So I don't think so, because he didn't charge me for all that bullshit. No, I don't think it did any damage down in there. He said he was able to dig everything out, and everything's fine and dandy. It's all good. She's in good shape. That's what he said. We'll see though. We'll see tomorrow. Cause that right after I get through over here, right after I finish, I'm gonna try to skedaddle down and get his money to him. So there's that. And I ain't gonna do nothing tomorrow, obviously. After I get this dropped, that'll be it. So I don't even know what today is. Is today Monday? Is it Monday? I think it's Monday, isn't it? So I ain't gonna get shit done Tuesday, except drop this shit off and then go deal with Betty. And hopefully I'll get there in time, because this Lowe's, they're really bad about, you go and you drop your trailer in a spot, okay? You don't drop it on a door. You drop it in a spot, okay? And separate from it, and then you go bobtail over to the other side of the place, and hopefully somebody will go pick up your trailer and go put it on a door, and hopefully they'll unload it and shit without fucking your shit up. This is the place, the only place, that has ever fuckered up a strap. They cut my strap. They couldn't get it loose, so they cut the motherfucker. This Lowe's right here. This DC. So that's what's going on tomorrow. And I might take Wednesday off. Get some shit done with Black Betty. See if I can't go ahead and get that IRP shit knocked out. Because that's going to take some time. And I got the fucking money, so I might as well do it. What else? That starts the clock. Once the clock starts, then I gotta start signing up with all the carrier packets, signing up with all the brokerages. So it's in effect. I'm back in Texas. I wanna get some shit done while I'm here, and then I'm gonna tear ass and go make some money for a minute, and then I'll come back. Probably have to rob a bank somewhere along the way. I don't know. I gotta go out for 2 weeks and work really, really hard with this bitch. Try to gather up some dollar bills. So there's that. That's what's going on. And that's all that's going on. Ain't nothing special. Just I made it to Texas. I'm sleeping in Texas like I said I was. Bubble guts and all. I got everything cleared out though. I got everything cleared up. Everything's fine and dandy. Yeah, that's what I saw. Storms in the northwest, or some kind of trough there, and then they're gonna plunge down here into Texas and New Mexico and shit. Oh, you saw the Dummy of the Day awards? Yeah. And that dickhead next to me. There's always one in every crowd. It doesn't matter. Somebody's always going to try to creep up and bogart and shit. I don't know how he thought he was going to fit all that fucking truck and trailer in that much fucking space. Had to give him the no-no. sound, the no-no signal. He ain't coming over here. I ain't having it. Yeah. And he just looked at me with that blank stare like, what? What? I hear you. Probably gonna have to sell something. I don't know. I'm gonna eat this because I'm tired. I'm gonna go to bed. So I'm gonna tear into this and then save the rest for lunch tomorrow, probably, because I probably won't eat it all. All right, I think I covered everything. Hell, I didn't hit anybody on the way down here. Didn't kill anybody. Yeah, that news y'all don't care about. Yep, that's it. All right, we see y'all later. I'm gonna get after this barbecue, because, you know, it's got my name on it. And we'll see y'all down the road.